Hello friends, today we are going to perform an experiment to calibrate a thermocouple using a potentiometer. But before starting this experiment, you should know two most important things. First is that this is a potentiometer. So on a wooden frame, we have screwed constantin or magnin wire. This is in fact a long straight wire, but this has been folded multiple times using these copper strips on this board. The resistivity of this wire is approximately 50 times higher than the resistivity of this copper strip. So overall, we are going to neglect the resistance caused by these copper strips in this experiment. So if we connect a voltage across its terminals, then the principle of a potentiometer is that the potential dropped across a segment of a wire of uniform cross section and carrying a constant current is directly proportional to its length. Additionally, the potentiometer is a simple device used to measure the electrical potential. Now, let us move to the second point we need to know. We generally have a thermocouple in which we take two wires, like in this case we have taken copper and constantin wires, and have created two junctions by joining their two ends together. One end we keep at hot place and another end we keep at cold place. Now, the thermal conductivity of these two wires is different, so one conducts more than other. Overall, this results in the flow of current. So, an EMF generated using a thermocouple can be calculated using a potentiometer. So now we will use this potentiometer and calculate the EMF generated by this thermocouple. But at the beginning of this experiment, we will take potentiometer and our battery. First, we will calculate the resistance of this potentiometer wire and the EMF of the battery. Now, let us start our experiment. In this experiment, we need this potentiometer. Now, we have connected its terminals using a battery and a resistance box. Now we will connect this thermocouple in such a way that the copper wire is connected to point A and then constantin wire, and copper wire then connects to a galvanometer, and after that it is connected to a jockey. Now insert these two terminals, one in oil bath and another is in ice bath. In this way we can define hot and cold junction in this experiment. Take care of these hot and cold junction, because if you switch them, the polarity of the EMF generated will also switch. So you should decide the hot and cold end in this experiment carefully according to this diagram. Now place the jockey on the potentiometer wire and try to find out the neutral point. Neutral point is the point where galvanometer doesn't show any reading. But to find your stable point on this potentiometer board, you need to apply an appropriate resistance R in this resistance box. So, as a fair guess, I can suggest you that if you apply approximately 1 volt using this battery, then the applied resistance in the resistance box should be around 200 times the resistance of this resistance wire. That range will give you the possibility that you can easily observe your neutral point on this potentiometer board. The external resistance is so high just because the EMF generated in its thermocouple is of the order of around 40-41 microvolt per degree Celsius. So for each degree Celsius, 40-50 microvolt EMF changes. So the potential drop in this potentiometer wire should be of the same order for this comparison. That's why we have applied a heavy resistance in this resistance box, so that the major voltage is dropped only in this box and the potential drop in this potentiometer is in millivolt range. When the potential difference between point A and O is equal to the potential difference caused by this thermocouple, in that case they will cancel each other and the galvanometer will not show any reading. Now we will measure length of the wire from A to O, which is A to C and C to O in this case. Similarly, we will increase the temperature and note down the reading of the stable point. Finally, we will make a table of it. So in this table, in one column, we will write down the temperature, and in another column, we are going to write the length of the wire from point A to O, and finally, we can calculate the potential of the thermocouple using this formula. Here P is the potential drop per centimeter of the wire, which can be calculated using this formula, and L is the length of the wire we observed for neutral point. All these quantities in this formula for P are known, which are EMF of the battery, applied resistance in the resistance box, total length of the bridge wire, which is capital L, and the resistance of the bridge wire, which we have calculated at the beginning of this experiment. So in this way, we will prepare this table, and finally, we will plot a curve between the temperature of the hot junction and the thermo EMF. Generally, in some lab experiments, it is hard to increase temperature after a certain limit, but if we can go even higher temperatures, then we will observe a curve like this. Here, the point at which thermo EMF is maximum is your neutral point, and it is going to make a parabolic structure. So in this way, the calibration curve of a thermocouple can be obtained using a potentiometer. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, share my videos and subscribe to my channel. Keep supporting, keep donating. Have a good day.